my God, it's the final BBRW episode of 2K22. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of BGIW, episode 99. We're jumping straight into the action here tonight with a triple threat match. We got Hercule Slaughter from GHK, Wade Danielson, VGIW, and Gorilla. We've invited Hercule Slaughter over for this one. We just wanted a big, crazy match, so we got three very different wrestlers colliding in the ring tonight. Bit of a celebratory night, so we're not sweating the details too much here tonight. It's like the good old days back when the final episodes of 2K18 were actually VGIW versus GHK episodes. Look at Wade Danielson go! Former world champion right there, Wade Danielson, getting in the ring with Gorilla and Hercule. Oh, breaking up the pin there. Nice shot there. And now Wade Danielson, Gorilla squaring off. Gorilla pushing away Wade Danielson. And now Hercule and Gorilla. Look at this. Going for a jawbreaker. Gorilla staggered there. Now grabbing a hold of Wade Danielson. Taking him over to the corner. Face first. Stomping away now. Look at this. And now going for a bulldog. Connects. Grabbing Hercule Slaughter now, right now, on fire. He takes Gorilla over the ropes. And look at this. DDT. No, a stunner. And Gorilla tumbles to the outside. Hercule Slaughter now ready to continue brawling on the outside this triple threat match. Oh! Gorilla still standing though, but Hercule Slaughter giving a beatdown right now. Oh, into the announce table. Gorilla's back in to go and take on Wade. Gorilla can be surprisingly strong sometimes. That's something to keep in mind here in this matchup. There's the snake eyes, and now Hercule Slaughter with the beatdown. Oh, what an enziguri, and Gorilla in the corner now. And now a bulldog to Gorilla. Connects! Face first. Gorilla getting back to his feet, but Hercule Slaughter currently focusing on Wade Danielson. There's Wade with the escape. Going for the back of the leg. Now we did see, last time we saw Hercule Slaughter was on an episode of GHK, where he actually managed to get an upset victory over the Reaper. So this would be a big opportunity for Hercule if he can win a triple threat match with Wade Danielson in. He'll have won two matches back to back with VGIW World Champions in. Ooh, nice work there by Gorilla. Gorilla now dragging Wade Danielson center of the ring. Or slightly off actually, but still pinfall nonetheless. One, only a one count. And now Wade getting back to his feet here. Remember, VGIW Finale 3 is right around the corner. You can expect that in just a few days now. Gorilla over the ropes. Wade Danielson go for the Pele kick. Oh, and it connects. Wade Danielson already looking to try and put this match away, I feel, with moves like this. Oh, and an axe handle. A bit more simple, but still can do some damage. Two, and there's the kick out. Gorilla bringing Wade Danielson back up to his feet now. Look at this, German suplex. And now, oh, nice catch there. And a DDT busting open Gorilla. I don't think I've ever seen Gorilla be busted open before. But still Gorilla kicked out nonetheless. Hercule now looking to go after Wade here. Oh, nice strike there. Ground holder Hercule taking him around, but Hercule struggling. Nice work by Hercule Slaughter escaping here. Oh man, look at this. Into the corner. Nice work there by Hercule Slaughter. Oh my goodness. Right now, Hercule Slaughter has been on fire in this match. And now Wade Danielson though going for a pin on Hercule here, but Gorilla breaks it up straight away. Hercule's right back up on his feet, by the way. Nice shots there. Oh, didn't manage to make much of that. And a big shoulder breaker there from Gorilla. Hercule there staggering Gorilla, that big haymaker. Taking him into the corner, into the ropes here. But now focusing on Wade. Oh, Wade there, a little too fast. Wade, one of the greatest high flyers of all time. No doubt going to be a difficult wrestler to deal with. I imagine the key strategy would be to take Wade out of the equation to focus on taking the other wrestler out. But Wade Danielson with that bulldog there, that springboard bulldog. One, only a one count though. That's very interesting. Given that Gorilla is bleeding, you think that he'd be a lot weaker and more vulnerable, but he's enduring pretty well right at the moment. Okay, taking Gorilla into the corner. Oh, again though. Look at this, Famouser! Great stuff there by Wade Danielson. And now Wade taking Gorilla again. And into the corner. Look at this, face first. Oh, ramming the face into the corner and booting Hercule in the face there. Hercule's right back up though. And now Hercule looking to return the favor with Code Red. Oh, and that landed with such perfection right there. Absolutely incredible. Nice work there. Oh, Irish whip into the corner. On, look at this. I think I know Hercule here. He's looking to try and put this match away here with a spider suplex. And now up on the top rope with a five-star frog splash. One, two, no. Broken up at the very last second by Gorilla. Oh, snapping the neck. Hercule Slaughter, it looked like he was going to manage to put this one away, but no such luck. And now Gorilla looking to punish Hercule. Hercule roll out of the ring. Wade Danielson ran into a power slam. Echoes of that most recent GHK episode where he ran towards the Crusher. The Crusher caught him with a power slam there too. Oh, dodging the leg drop. Good work there by Wade. Staying competitive in this one. And now an Irish whip into the corner. Good way, Danielson looking to put this away. No, reversed by Gorilla there. And now, oh, what an uppercut there from Gorilla. Going for the pin now. One, two, and oh. Hercule got in the ring and Gorilla got up. I mean, he realized he'd have to deal with Hercule. Oh my God, that head scissors managed to land a leg drop on Wade. Two. Oh, despite taking two out at once there, Gorilla was still able to kick out before the three. Bring Gorilla back up. Nice punch there, taking Gorilla down. And boom with the bulldog. But Hercule's back up. Nice work there with that Hurricane Rana. And a standing shooting star. Hercule already racing up to the top rope once again. Hercule very athletic, very agile, it's got to be said, but also quite strong. Oh, but Wade dodging that arm drag. And now go for the leg. Ooh, tweaking the leg there. But Hercule with the kick in return, staying competitive in this. Gorilla back in the ring. So this match is far from over. Hercule kicking Gorilla in the corner. And now Hercule going for another bulldog. Oh, drilling Gorilla's head into the mat there. Stomping away now. My, oh my, this match is very interesting right here. Like, this has been, oh, wait a minute. Gorilla, go for the Gorilla Press Slam. Oh, I think it's over. Oh, it's over. It is over. Going for the pin. One, two, and there's the kick out. Hercule sort of hanging in there. And now Gorilla going for the arm. Slapping the arm there. Going for Wade, now Wade Danielson. German suplex from Gorilla. Gorilla is big, he's powerful, and he is just overwhelming at the moment. But Wade Danielson flying across the air, catching him with the moonsault. And Wade thinking about what he's got to do now to deal with this lumbering giant of a gorilla. Oh, Gorilla's back on his feet. Wade's got to think fast here. Here we go. Look at this, going for the tree of woe there. Some great core strength from Wade Danielson. Another reason why he was able to make it to being a world champion. Now choking out Gorilla there. The Gorilla's rolled out of the ring to try and recover. Famouser from Wade Danielson to Hercule. And now dragging him away from the ropes. Closer to the center of the ring. Going for the pin now. One, two, and there's the kick out. Oh, stomping on the back of the head there. And on the arm. Nice catch there. And now look at this. Right across the back. Hercule's psyching himself up here. Got to try and make a big comeback here. Springboard moonsault from the top rope. But they're immediately broken up. Oh, back and forth here. And, oh, attempted to get a Pele kick in there, but no dice. Nice throw there by Gorilla. And now going to hold the Wade Danielson. Going for Snake Eyes here in the corner. Gil rising back to his feet. Wade Danielson's back up. But Gorilla there out-muscling Wade. Oh! I think Wade's got to rely more on that high-flying ability if he wants to overcome Gorilla. Because these two are not overcoming Gorilla in terms of strength, that's for sure. One, two, and there's the kick out. Wade's back up again. And a Famouser leaping up. That vertical leap would have been impressive there. Now going up to the top right, might be looking to put this one away. He is 450 splash. One, two, no, Gorilla kicks out. Oh my God, this match has been getting down to the wire at this point. Oh, you see those chops back and forth here. Soul butt kick, there we go. And another kick there. Turning to Hercule, chop after chop, a kick and an enziguri. Kick to the head. Boom, busting open Hercule. Now only Wade, the only one not busted open in this match. Oh, Wade's sucking himself up here. But a German suplex into a bridging pin there. That's a surprisingly technical from Gorilla. And now, oh, maybe a bit of double teaming here. Look at this. Down goes Wade, double Russian leg sweep. And now into the corner. And, oh, catching Gorilla there with that kick. Oh, wait a minute, line salt. Look at Hercule go. One, two, no. Hercule frustrated, but keeping his eyes on the prize here. Irish whip into the corner. Going to be looking for that spider suplex. Can he manage to do this to Gorilla? I know Hercule's strong, but this is going to be a hell of an achievement. Oh my God, he's going to do it. Oh, that's incredible right there. And now on the top rope. Going for the frog splash, but he's been reversed by Gorilla. Oh, Gorilla there trying to knock them both down with that kick. To the outside. And now going off the Wade. But Wade with a stinging chest chop there. And Pele kick. Gorilla's dazed and confused, but Hercule didn't quite catch Hercule. So Hercule now go for an inverted DDT there. Nice kick to the back there. And Hercule once again psyching himself up. Irish whip over the ropes to the outside. And now look at this. Pressure around the head. Another big kick to the back. And Hercule, what is he thinking here? Oh, stomping on Wade. In comes Gorilla. He had to abandon his plans once Gorilla re-entered the ring. And now look at this. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Hercule wins. Hercule wins. Given this is the last BGIW episode of 2K24, then this is actually, of 2K22, sorry, this is very impressive. You know, that is great stuff for Hercule Slaughter right there. Oh my goodness. Oof. This was a crazy close triple threat match, it must be said. Hercule gave it everything he had to try and come out on top. Gorilla, Wade, they all did very well. But Hercule Slaughter standing on top in this one with some impressive feats in this match. We got one more match. We got two more matches for you tonight. Sorry, the Vols advertised for a second there, so don't go anywhere. We got plenty of great wrestling action to come. All right, for our next match, we got VVC, the Lizard King Venom, and the Bull, Terry Adams. This should be interesting. We got three very different wrestlers here, but all with their own, but they're all a little bit different, all a little bit, you know, wrestlers that in the beginning you would not have seen doing particularly well, but have definitely overcome some obstacles in their time. The Lizard King Venom surviving two sit-out tombstones from Rebellion to become a trainer at the training center and still win matches. You know, Venom's proved himself to be very capable in the ring. You got the Bull Terry Adams, who started life as a jobber, but now is a former world champion, I believe a two-time world champion at that. Then, of course, you got VVC, who has been getting better and better as the years go on. Despite having a goofy little gimmick, he is a star in that ring. He's a former Trios champion, a former UK champion, people are saying he has the potential to go all the way to potentially becoming a future world champion. That's the whispers I've been hearing, especially when he's been out wrestling the likes of the Reaper, you know, the current world champion. All right, now though, Venom in control right here. The Lizard King looking to hold control of this match, and right now he's doing a damn good job of it. Look at those punches raining down. Our main event tonight after this will be the Wild Card Championship match between Untouchable Natalie Reed and Celestine Ingeborg. That'll be a hardcore match. That means no count out, no disqualification. Those women will be destroying each other. Down goes VVC. Into the corner. Venom is looking to put this one away quickly from the looks of things. Look at these clubbing strikes and clotheslines. There's the pin, but VVC breaks it up early. And now look at this. Oh, nice work there, but no dice. Pushing VVC away. Kick and a Famouser, boom, driving down the Venom, the Lizard King. Now VVC going after the ball, and a great dropkick there. If VVC can win this, he'll have beaten another world champion. Informal world champion, the Bull Terry Adams, going for a splash here. One, two, and there's the kick out. But you can see that VVC is not wasting any time. He's getting right back into this. Venom's back in the ring. Oh, nice. Venom there. Oh, and Terry Adams go back and forth here. The Lizard versus the Bull. Into the corner. And now taking VVC into the corner. You can see what Terry Adams is planning, can't you? Look at this. Boom! Two birds, one stone. Oh. You can see the absolute beatdown. And neckbreaker. Great stuff here. The Lizard King in full control at the moment, but they're losing it in an instant. That's how quickly momentum can shift here in VGIW. Remember, this is the last episode of VGIW of 2K22. Then there's just like a Kitsune Kingdom episode, a GHK episode, and VGIW Finale 3. Then it's 2K24. Which is going to be an exciting time. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for VGIW Finale. Yeah. Hall of Glory is the biggest annual event, but every 2 years or so, we make the shift to a new WWE game. So After 2K24, we won't be shifting until WWE 2K26, for instance. So, VJW Finale 3 is like a big marathon victory lap where we just celebrate the times that we've had, you know, pretty much anyone and everyone gets involved, or as many people as possible get involved wrestlers-wise on the channel. Oh, very close there. And we end up with a huge marathon event. It's a huge finale, is a huge celebration, and then we switch over to 2K24. So be sure to check in. That is going to be an exciting time. Let me tell you, this is the most packed finale to date. BBC and Terry Adams going back and forth here. Look at this, carrying BBC around. BBC was struggling, so Terry Adams there, look at that, regaining control. Terry Adams is very smart about these things. Look at that, he's just getting BBC out of the way so he could focus on Venom. Oh, but it didn't work. That plan did not succeed, and now, look at this. BBC is bleeding quite notably there. He's got a nasty gash on the face. And you can see he's wrestling a bit blind. Oh, there was an attempted Lizard King punch. The BBC with the Russian leg sweep. And now, Terry Adams challenging BBC here. BBC chopping so wildly that it accidentally caught the referee again, though. I think VVT's wrestling half blind at the moment. One, two, and they're breaking up the pin. Got to give VVT this. Given that he's wrestling half blind, he's not doing half bad right now. Going for the stomp. Nice work there. Dragging Venom away from the ropes. Going for a dancing, spinning leg drop. And now, looking for Disco Fever! Groove! Ah, no! That fact that he can't see properly out of one eye at the moment, that's clouded his vision. He couldn't connect with Disco Fever! And now Terry Adams coming in here to deal with Lizard King. Oh, look at this, up on the top rope. What is Venom planning here? Oh my god, a super Samoan drop! Oh! That was a hell of a FUD. Going for a pin now. One, two, and Terry Adams kicks out. The crowd are loving this one. Oh, barely dodging the Lizard King punch there. That was mere inches away from the face. You can tell Venom is getting dangerous now. He's starting to really build up some momentum in this match. Oh, trying to deal with both BBC and the Bull. Going for Snake Eyes there. Terry Adams is back up. BBC's recovered. Oh, man. Now we got a full freeway brawl right now. Grabbed a hold of VVC, lifting him up, and boom! Oh my god! Driving him down there. VVC groggling, getting back to his feet, trying to fight back. Here we go, kick to the midsection, and a neck breaker! And now going for Terry Adams here. Facebuster! Oh. Here we go now. Nice work there to take down Terry Adams. And now going for those elbow drops to try and keep him down. Again and again and again with those elbow drops. Going for the pin. One, two. Oh, VVC, let's go. And you could see there, Terry Adams actually would have kicked out after the three count. But I think he realized that Venom had a chance of breaking the pin up, so didn't want to risk it, didn't want to chance it. When you can only see properly out of one eye, then your sense of depth perception can get thrown off. So VVC can't have been sure how close Venom was, didn't want to take that risk, because if Venom broke up the pin, that would have put him in a disadvantageous spot. Venom could have attacked him, so VVC, realizing that it would be better to play it safe, broke the pin up to try and do it. Obviously, we know better. We know that VVC could have won the match there, But I can't blame BBC in his current circumstances for breaking up the pin there. Oh, look at that. Because in his position, he doesn't know if Venom was close enough to break up the pin due to the depth perception issue, due to having only one good eye at the moment. And if that had been broken up, he would have been in trouble. Venom could have laid the beat down on him like Venom's currently doing. Oh god, what's Venom thinking here? Irish whip. Oh, look at this. Oh my god. Oh! Venom's got the fists. And now, oh, doing the same thing to Terry now. Nobody has an answer for the best pure striker in VGIW. Oh. Remember when Michael Cole would say that all the time about The Undertaker, even when there were, like, MMA people, even when there would be, like, Brock Lesnar? Oh, wait, I'm not supposed to say that name now, am I? Oh! Okay, now, look at this. Go away. Venom is on a rampage right now. Going to the corner. Here we go. Terry Adams is in trouble. The Lizard King Punch. One, two, no. Terry Adams hanging in there. Awesome. Additional punches for good measure. They're not royal punches, but they're certainly going to do some damage. Saying that, Terry Adams, look at this, finding the strength to keep pushing. That's what got him to the top of the league, got him to the world title picture. BBC, though, with the takedown now. And look at that, that's what we expect from BBC. Oh, that's just disrespectful right there. Oh, look at BBC go now. Going for a neck breaker. Brilliant work there. And now going to the corner. Oh, changed his mind. I think he was thinking about Disco Fever, but he's got something else in mind now. Into the corner now. Going for a scoop slam! And now, going for the pin here. One, two, and there's the kick out. In the ball, Terry Adams now into the ring. Oh, look at this. The Terry Flosion connects. Smooth as silk. But the Lizard King breaks it up. Nice back and forth here. Uranagi. And now Terry Adams. Oh, look at that. Release suplex. Release belly-to-belly suplex. And the Lizard King rolling out of the ring. And now, up in the air, power jackknife powerbomb. Terry Adams showcasing his strength right now with this level of power. Oh, nice shot there to the chest. Stomping down on the arm. And again, stomping down on the arm. You can see that VVC there looks uncertain on what to do. Here we go, now taking BC into the corner. Boom, with snake eyes. But the Lizard King. Boom, headbutt there. Lizard King punch. Okay, it's over. One, two, no. Terry Adams hanging in there. Oh, the BBC gonna stop Venom from hitting a second Lizard King punch. There's a nice forearm. Venom's back up already. Oh, what's he thinking? Taking VVC here. And using the... And look at that pressure on the arm there. And now, neck breaker. Good work there by Venom. Turning to the ball, Terry Adams now. Oh, a headbutt to the back of the head. And now... Oh my God! What a package. Here we go. The Lizard King Punch. One, two, three. The Lizard King wins. What a shocking result. What an upset. But the Lizard King coming out on top here tonight. My, oh my, what a match. What a match. Oh my god. Now look at that. Venom celebrating. I don't think anyone expected this outcome. Oh god, he's gonna run off the referee. Might be a return for the Lizard King based on this result. A crowd in disbelief, but they're cheering anyway. Well, it's time to move on to our main event for the VGIW Wildcard Championship. We got Untouchable, Natalie Reed, and Celestine Ingeborg. So, of course, if I remember correctly, Celestine actually recently won the belt from Natalie Reed. So Natalie Reed here, as part of her rematch, you know, champions do have the option for a rematch for the title to try and win it back. And of course, Untouchable here, just as a general challenger, because it is the hardcore title, anyone can challenge for it. Oh man, there's the champ right now, Celestine. Here we go, the match begins. Now, of course, we do also have two former world champions in the mix here. Untouchable and Natalie Reed have both been VGIW Women's World Champion before. So they know what it's like to be at the very top. Oh, nice back and forth here. And now, clothesline! Great work there. And now turning to Natalie Reed. Boom! Nice strike across the chest. And a spine buster! No time wasted right now. These three are getting to big power moves right now. Untouchable being sent to the outside. Look at this. Up in the air for a powerbomb, but now, oh, Celestine! Roll with the roll up. One! Only one count. Untouchable getting back into the ring. Untouchable standing 7 feet tall. By the way, great update. 2K24 has allowed it that Untouchable can now be 7 feet tall. They've also increased the minimum heights, unfortunately, so some of the really small wrestlers are going to be slightly taller, but that's a small thing. I'm willing to let the small wrestlers have a few more inches if it means Untouchable can finally be 7 feet tall and not just canonically in storyline. You know, I could actually legitimately show it off this time, which will be nice. Look forward to that with 2K24. Oh, nice beatdown there from Untouchable. Going for the arm now. Oh, snapping the arm. Now the Reed rolling to the outside. And Untouchable now. Look at this. Oh! Kicking Celestine in the head there. And now Untouchable sending Celestine to the outside. And Celestine is recovering on the outside right now. And so now the brawl is taking place outside the ring. Untouchable dismantling one of our announce tables. And now Natalie Reed stomping away at Celestine here. Oh, nice clubbing blow there. And oh, chucking her into the side of the ring. That is a painful landing. Natalie Reed, meanwhile, looking under the ring. Oh, Natalie has a chair, but Untouchable disarms her immediately there. Untouchable is in full control of this match right now, fully dictating the pace here. Oh man, look at this now. Oh my god! Cracking chair shots all over the head, the legs, the body. But Natalie Reed still gets up nonetheless, but immediately caught by Untouchable. And now, sledgehammer in hand, Celestine go to work on Natalie Reed. But Natalie's back up again. Oh, the spear! The spear! The spear! Natalie Reed is putting this one away very, very quickly from the looks of things. Two, and there we go. Still in this. The match continues. And Natalie Reed, the fact that she was able to enjoy all that, still landing a spear to try and put this match away. Gotta hand it to Natalie Reed. That's what makes her so bloody dangerous in the ring. Such a great competitor. Untouchable now. Oh, Celestine there escaping out of the ring, being very escaping out of the corner, very slippery there. And now Irish whip over the ropes to the outside. Untouchable recovering and getting back to her feet now. Oh, here we go. Raking the back and into the table. Untouchable in Natalie Reed now. Lily's ready to square off. Irish whip over the ropes. Oh, look at this. That strike with Natalie Reed. Oh, doing that to a seven-footer like Untouchable is impressive. Meanwhile, now Celestine with the kendo, but immediately disarmed by Natalie Reed. Untouchable now. Grabbing a hold of Celestine Ingeborg. And boom with the snake eyes. Here we go. Oh, what an elbow there. Caught and nice takedown. Going for the pin. Immediately broken up by Celestine at the count of one. And Celestine now with the dodge there. Celestine is proving to be particularly evasive. That is going to be difficult to... Oh my god, the claw! That choking hold! Untouchable's not going to be the same after that. That seemed... What I found is that can slowly suck the life out of your opponents. Untouchable will no doubt not be at 100% after that. That's the thing about... Celestine, she doesn't have a straight knockout blow. She slowly saps the life out of her opponents. It may only take one time, but sometimes I've seen her just the opponent wither away slowly. They'll escape the first time. They may escape the second time, but by that third time, they're so weak that it's too much. And Natalie Reed has no one to help her here, and she's being slowly beaten by Celestine. No! Look at Natalie go! Oh, Untouchable back in there. And I think the sledgehammer caught Natalie on the top of the head there. That is a nasty, nasty accident. And down goes Natalie Reed. Untouchable and Celestine here. Oh, into the ropes. And now using the ropes for leverage. Nice work there. Oh, there's a strike. Celestine looking for a clothesline. Boom! Delivered with force there. And now going for the pin. One! Only a one count. And now, look at this, grabbing the sledgehammer. Oh, across the back there. In across the midsection. But up comes Natalie Reed again with the takedown. The crowd are loving this matchup. It is brutal, but all three wrestlers have really been putting their miles in this match. And the strength of Natalie Reed. Oh! Going for the pin now. One, two, and Celestine kicks out. Now Untouchable grabbing a hold of Natalie Reed here. Oh no. No, no, no. The sledgehammer's behind. Oh! The tailbone right on the head of the sledgehammer. You can see there, taking a second to rest and trying to recover there. Oh lordy, up in the air. That's a over 7 foot drop. That must be practically 8 foot. Onto the sledgehammer again with the spinning side slam. And now the pinfall. One, two, three. We got a new champion. Honestly, I cannot say that I'm terribly surprised by that outcome. Good lord, what a matchup. And our last main event of 2K22. Only stop, last VGIW main event of 2K22. Like I said, the only other stops for 2K22. Kitsune Kingdom, GHK, and finally VGIW Finale 3. Then it's WWE 2K24 time, baby. Thank you for watching. Please be sure to leave a like on the video, comment down below your favorite match, share this video with your friends, and subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified of future videos on the channel. We'll see you next time.